previous video, I mentioned that one action that could make it necessary to restore lost settings and program files is replacement of the data logger's lithium battery. In this video, I will demonstrate how to replace the CR1000X lithium battery. These instructions are also found in the CR1000X manual. Because this will cause a loss of settings, program files, and data, follow the instructions in the video backing up and restoring data logger setting files using device configuration before proceeding. Campbell Scientific data loggers have an internal lithium backup battery. When the data logger is disconnected from 12 volts main power, the lithium battery maintains the data logger clock and data. When the data logger is reconnected to 12 volts, it seamlessly begins logging data again. The CR1000X measures its lithium battery once per day and stores that value in the status table. It can also be viewed in station status. When the lithium battery voltage is below 2.7 volts, it should be replaced. Station status will provide a warning in red when the lithium battery needs replacement. The replacement battery is listed on the CR1000X ordering info page under replacement parts. This is a AA size 3.6 volt lithium battery. This could be purchased directly from Campbell Scientific, but it may also be possible to obtain it or a compatible substitute locally. Contact Campbell Scientific support with any questions about obtaining a replacement battery. To perform this procedure, I will need the following: a computer running device configuration utility, a replacement lithium battery, Campbell Scientific part number 30028, a flat-bladed screwdriver with a 2.5 millimeter blade, such as Campbell Scientific part number 8125, a number 2 Phillips head screwdriver, a nut driver with a 5/16 inch socket. After backing up my data logger, I'm ready to begin the process of replacing the battery. I turn off the power supply and unplug the green plug-in power connector. Next, I use the flat-bladed screwdriver to loosen the locking screws on the terminal connectors. Now, I can unplug the terminal connectors. Because these connectors are removable, I can leave all my sensors connected to them, which saves a lot of time. To remove my CR1000X from the enclosure backplate, I use the number 2 Phillips screwdriver to loosen the four mounting screws, and then slide the data logger to the right and remove it from the enclosure. Now I'm ready to take the CR1000X to a tabletop or other flat surface to finish the process. With the wiring panel facing down, I remove the two screws on the corners. Now I carefully pry the silver clamshell away from the wiring panel. This can be difficult and may require working along the edges until I feel the connectors separate. Take care during this part to avoid accidentally scratching or distorting the wiring panel. With the data logger clamshell separated from the wiring panel, I use the nut driver and Phillips screwdriver to remove the remaining four screws holding the clamshell together. I carefully pry the two halves apart to open the clamshell. Take care not to damage the rubber gasket. This side of the clamshell has a desiccant pack that keeps the data logger electronics dry. If I have a replacement desiccant pack, I can tape it here. Now I can carefully pry out the lithium battery using the flat-bladed screwdriver. At this point, my CR1000X loses its clock, data, and program, and is returned to factory default settings. I replace the lithium battery with the new one, and now I can reassemble the data logger. I make sure the rubber gasket is correctly positioned before replacing the screws and tightening them. Next, I line up the two connectors that connect the clamshell to the wiring panel and gently press together until the data logger is securely seated. I reattach the two corner screws and the CR1000X is ready to be returned to the enclosure. I remount the data logger inside the enclosure. I reconnect the terminal connectors and the green plug-in power connector. Secure the terminal connectors in place using the flathead screwdriver. Turn on the power supply. The final step is to connect to the data logger with my computer, open Device Configuration Utility, and restore the backup I made following the procedure from the video, backing up and restoring data logger setting files using Device Configuration. The system is now up and running again. With a stable 12-volt power supply, the new lithium battery should last about 5 to 7 years. Best practice is to check station status regularly to ensure that the lithium battery voltage is not dropping faster than expected.